on here, but not the same one. No. So if you want to pummel me with all of your facts, feel free to call in at 512-686-0279. That's 512-686-0279. All right. And with that, I think we are going to hop into some calls. Is there anyone that you think you'd like to talk to first?
Mike.
Let's go with Mike.
Mike.
All right.
In Germany.
Mike in Germany. You're on the air with V and Eric.
Hi. Oh, man, I'm happy to be first now. A long-time listener, but first-time caller. And, I have a problem that I needed some advice.
For sure. What's going on?
So I'm an atheist. So I was raised Christian. But like many Christians in Germany, even the people who identify as Christian do not really believe it is more like a cultural thing,
right?
You know, and I cannot pinpoint the moment where I became an atheist. It was more like an outgrowing thing, you know. It was like I always say, like, I mean, as a child, I believed in Santa Claus, mm-hmm. the Easter Bunny, and yeah. God. And right. Now I don't believe in any of them. Okay. But now I have a girlfriend who is a Muslim. And there was sometimes the issue that she has a genuine fear of God, a genuine fear of divine punishment. And to be honest, I've never met anyone who is like really afraid of that, something like that. So I don't really know how to respond to that.
Yeah. Yeah, that's rough. Because that is a very genuine fear. Like, I remember that feeling, and it's real.
Yeah, for Christians, a lot of what we heard in the Recovering from Religion support groups was a fear of hell.
Yeah.
And it still stuck with them for years and years, and it's what kept them a part of the Christian religion and kept them in the community.
Yeah. My first thought would be to... I guess I have a question for you. Does she talk to you about this? Is this something that you guys have brought up, or is this just you observing this from a distance?
We talk about a lot about religion. I'm not trying to deconvert her, and mm-hmm. she's not trying to convert me, but we are exchanging arguments back and forth. Mm-hmm. And,
okay.
Does she claim that her God is a loving God?
No, not really.
Okay.
Because I already tried telling her, I mean, what kind of God would it be who punishes his or her followers mm-hmm. for small things? I mean, it would be a petty, vindictive God, right? But it doesn't work because she doesn't necessarily believe that Allah is a good God.
Mm. Yeah, not necessarily like petty, but also abusive.
Yeah. Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
It is. It is a form of abuse.
And absolutely.
It's strange because it's perpetuated without any one person kind of pulling the strings. It's just a mindset that people inflict on themselves. So I think you're doing a really good thing, which is talking with her about this and being open and exchanging your ideas. And the fact that she's sharing these fears with you means that she trusts you a lot, which is good.
Yeah.
And that's something that you should definitely attempt to uphold as much as you can. At this point, I would say listen to her when she's expressing these fears, and ask honest questions. Ask questions not to dissuade her or not to deconvert her necessarily, but to get her to verbalize exactly what she's afraid of, because a lot of the time, once we verbalize things and make those logical connections out loud, it can actually alleviate some of that fear.
Yeah, yeah, we've seen that a lot in the support groups. And in fact, coming soon in Germany, we hope to have some support groups in Germany itself. But what we've seen is once folks start to talk about through their fears, through their doubts, and they hear themselves talk, instead of it just bouncing around inside of their head, it suddenly like either becomes like, oh, that makes sense, or oh, this is nuts. This is fucking crazy what I'm thinking.
Right. There are leaps in logic that we are trained to make when we grow up in a religion that are not able to be pinpointed until we're asked to explain how we got from point A to point B.
Especially because we were mm-hmm. given these so-called quote unquote bits of logic when we couldn't even understand logic.
Right.
When we were children and didn't have that part of our brain even fully developed.
Exactly. Another thing you could try maybe is I don't know where you are necessarily in your community, but if there are any kind of ex-Muslim support groups, mm-hmm. not even necessarily atheist support groups, because I know that can feel maybe a little bit alienating, at least at first. If there are other people who were Muslim and who were dealing with these things that she could interact with and just also bounce those off of them, because it kind of helps to have a cultural similarity when you're talking about this as well.
Yeah. On the recoveringfromreligion.org website, there is a tab on the upper part of it that has resources. And in fact, I was just looking through this the other day to speak with a gentleman, and there is a whole section on ex-Muslim resources that you might even be able to hop into and ask some of those questions. I think much better than my background would be able to provide.
Right. I think we're a little bit hamstrung here just because we ourselves have not experienced the Muslim faith, and so we can't speak to exactly the arguments that she might be bringing to you or exactly the fear. But I think that would be my best understanding.
Yeah. I was more afraid of death and less afraid of hell.
Mm. Does that help at all?
Yeah, I think that helps. Yeah, over time. And there's some signs. I mean, the reason why I'm calling just now was because there was a situation yesterday where she had fear that some other person, some other Muslim, might pray to Allah to break up our relationship.
Wow.
And it's just, yeah.
Yeah, that was a real visceral fear for her.
Yes. Yeah, she was really nervous. So that was in the street, and got into a conversation with some Muslims who were proselytizing and handing out Qurans in the street. Mm. And this is something that I noticed. Me walking around with her is, for some Muslims, it's like a magnet. They see. Yeah. Woman who is a Muslim, and then me, German, and they ask, "Are you Muslim?" And then I say, "No, I'm an atheist." And then you already see that in their eyes that they are, "Oh my God, he's going to deconvert her."
Yep.
And so in one situation, it went even so far that the Muslim told me that, "Oh, you have to go to this mosque right now. You have to convert. This is not okay with you two here." And something like that happened yesterday. I got into a debate. It got a little bit heated, I think I'm partly to blame for that, but I think I could have also gotten a lot more angry, considering that the Muslim called me a schizophrenic and other stuff. So, but anyhow, after that talk, she suddenly started to think, what happens if this man now starts praying to break up the relationship? And she started shivering, and really, it was wow. Like that.
Well, I think that you're doing the right thing for right now, because you're showing her that you care, that you're caring without doing it for a reward. You're caring it simply for her because you love her. And so keeping doing this is something that I think is incredibly valuable for her. And in addition to that, just think about how you came to become an atheist. It wasn't something that happened overnight either. If I remember that right, is that what he...
It was outgrowing it.
But Eric, for me, it was... I was never really a believer.
Got it, yeah.
I never had a fear of God, never a fear of hell. This concept is just so alien to me. You understand?
Coming out of a... I know that you're not trying to deconvert her, but coming out of a religion is something that takes a process, and you have to be shown different ways of being that that you are doing right now to the best of your ability. And honestly, I applaud you for showing how much you love her and being there for her, even though she's frightened. And you are probably one of the best persons for her to be around mm-hmm. when she goes through those things.
Exactly. The more that you are there for her, the more you're going to be showing her that there is the possibility of being a good person, being a kind, caring person outside of that religion. And that's going to leave that door open for her. And I think I just end by saying that you clearly care a lot, and that's really, really good and really important, but you also can't take on the responsibility of her fear. If she is afraid, you can be there for her, you can listen to her, and you can try and mitigate that however you can, but it is going to be her journey to either get out of or not. So yes, you are doing all of the right things as far as I can tell. And just calling into the show proves how much you're thinking about this and trying to put your best foot forward. But make sure that you are taking care of yourself too, and not tying yourself to her emotional state in an unhealthy way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you so much for calling.
Thanks, guys. That's really helpful. Yeah. Okay. Thanks. Bye.
Oof.
That's a tough situation.
It is very tough because if you haven't grown up in a religion where you were really honestly convinced of something, you're not going to be able to fully grasp somebody who is living in terror of a non-existent entity.
And it totally comes across how much Mike really cares for his girlfriend, and it's moving. It's really moving.